Hello and welcome to livealittlehigher.com. Shavua Tov. We continue this week learning Duties of the Heart, Hadot HaLevavot, by Rabbi Bahia Ibn Pakuda, who lived more than 1,000 years in Spain. And he's teaching us about how to use our heart in the service of God, how to feel God, how to love God. And today we will be talking about the creation of the world and how it's so important to come to understand that everything was done by Hashem. Many people think that there was a big explosion and the world created itself, and he comes to explain this and tell us how it's not normal to think like this, because if there's a creator, if there's a creation, there has to be a creator. So when we observe this world, says Rabbi Pakuda, we find that it's composite, made up of many parts. We see that the world is not just a simple creation, it's made of many things. If you take one apple, you'll see it has a peel, it has a fruit, it has seeds. It's not just made of one thing. And when we observe this world and we realize that it's made of many parts and that not one of its parts was not fashioned and ordered, for we perceive with our senses and minds that the world is like a well-built house. Like a person that's thinking, that's analyzing, that's looking at the world, that's meditating on the creation of the world, comes to realize that the world is like a well-built house and there has to be an architect behind this house. So the skies above serve as the ceiling of the house, the earth is spread out like a carpet, the stars are arranged and they are like the lamps in your house, and all objects are stored inside like treasures. Everything is ready for the intended use. So what he's telling us, Rabbi Pakuda, here is not only God created an intelligent world that is created with purpose, but it also has a function. Everything that is in this world has something to give to us. So man is like the master of the house. He's the ruler of the house who makes use of everything inside it. Like Hashem created the whole world for you. That's the truth. That's why man was created at the end. He was the last creation before Shabbat, because it is for Hashem to show us that everything else is for the use of humanity. So the different kinds of plants are provided for his good, and the various animals also serve to benefit the man. And as David said, King David, you have made him master over the works of your hands, placed all things at his feet, all sheep and cattle, also the beasts of the field, the birds of the heavens, and the fish of the sea, that which moves along the ocean paths. And the sequence of sunrise and sunset determines the times of the day and night. And the solar ascension and the declension produce cold and heat. And summer and winter and all the seasons, fall and spring, with all their blessings. So everything that God created really is for humanity, is for us. We are masters of the world, and we should be the masters of the world and not let the world be the masters of us. You know, you are a master of your life. There's people who everything around them controls them. The substance abuse, they get dependent on things. Why? Because the creation becomes their masters. But in reality, we have to become masters of creation. It is for us. It is for us to use, but to use in a holy way, in a godly way. So the circuit of the spheres in their various orbits, the stars, the planets, racing along calculated courses, everything is precise and perfect. The speed, everything is measured and is intended for man's benefit. Everything is for our benefit. And as King Shlomo said, he has made everything right in its time. He has also set the world in their heart. And there is a time for everything, a moment for all concerns under heaven. And so the composite and structure of nature, of all these apparent as a whole and in each of the parts, when we examine plants and animals, we find them to be composed of the four elements, which are fire, air, water, and earth. These are the four elements of the world. Everything is made out of these elements. You see that there's people who are more fire in them, they have more passion. Then you see people that are more air, they're more like their head is up there. And then you see people that are more like water, they're smooth, they go like this. And then you see people that are earthy, they're connected to the ground. So all these elements are distinct and incompatible. You could not mix them if you think about it, but there's a certain way that Hashem allows us to mix them. Like if you mix water and earth, you get clay and you can build a house. So this is the magic of God. From here we see that all these elements really are not man-made, they're made by God. You cannot make earth. Not even in the best laboratory you can make earth out of nothing. Hashem is the only one that has been able to make a world out of nothing. He makes something out of nothing. But human beings can make something out of nothing. We need something to make something. And that's what makes us understand that the world was created by Hashem. And it was not an accident of I don't know what, that it just exploded and it created itself. An intelligent person, says Rabbi Pikuda, comes to analyze and understand that there's a creator by looking at the combinations of all these elements. So since all things that exist come from the elements and are combinations of them, and since we know that these elements, because of their disagreement amongst them, do not mix on their own, nor do they combine by their nature, it strikes our mind and we are convinced in our souls that what unites them is something other than them. So there's something bigger, something out of them, that is the one that's able to unite them. And that's Hashem. So their matter is that primal matter, which is the origin of the four elements, their original substance, and their form is that first universal form, which is the root of all form. So the composition and combination are evident in the world as a whole and in all of its parts. And this is what demonstrates that whatever is composite must be brought into existence. So we see that they were brought into existence by a higher being, a higher intelligence. And it's impossible for a thing to have made itself. This Rabbi Pikuda comes to explain to us. It's impossible that something comes and makes itself by itself. It's not possible. Like you could talk to a person that believes in the Big Bang, and you can tell him, okay, tell me something, your house, was it made by an explosion or someone had to build it? And they'll tell you, no, somebody had to build the house. I had an architect, I had an engineer, I had construction workers here, I had to buy floors, I had to buy bathrooms, it doesn't make itself. So if a house doesn't make itself, so much more, a world that is so complex and so perfect, how could we ever come to believe that it made itself? So there are men who, that we say here that now if such a claim is rejected when it's made about a petty and insignificant little water wheel, like he's talking about an irrigation water wheel, that nobody would think that the water wheel was made by itself. There was someone behind it that created it, engineered it, put it together, put it to work, so it could irrigate the ground. How, if we think that this was made by somebody, how can we even come to imagine that or claim that the whole celestial sphere was made by itself in its perfection? So here Rabbi Pikuda says, we all know that where there is no designer, intent, no trace of wisdom or proficiency will be found. Surely you would agree that if a man were accidentally to spill some ink into a blank sheet of paper, it is impossible that it would take the shape of orderly writing and legible lines. So he gives more examples about the world, about explaining if we contemplate the world and we contemplate every creation, not only Hashem's creations, but men's creations, will come to understand that when there's a creation, there is a creator. It's impossible. It's not possible that if there's a creation, there's no creator. So all that we have cited in demonstrating the existence of the creator from the perspective of his works is sufficient for anyone who will understand and admit the truth. It is also sufficient to answer those who say that the world is eternal, and they refute their contentions. And he says at the end, know this well. Make sure that you contemplate, that you know this, that you put it in your head. So I wish you a good week, a happy week, a healthy week, and live a little higher. Thank you.